Okay, so the first thing I do is I determine which side is the tip and which side is the base. Base and tip. And I'll take a hammer stone and rough it out. Now these are both hard hammer stones. This one is smoother than this one. But this one is heavier than this one. And it's obviously more dense and more compacted. But this isn't as good for flaking as this one. This one will actually catch the edges of your stone and peel off flakes. Whereas this is mainly for removing something stubborn, like a big lump. You can smack it with this and it doesn't take much effort to knock it off. But the smooth hammer stones really don't work as well as the rough hammer stones. So I'm going to use a rough, hard hammer stone. I think this is a basalt or something similar. I like mine to be round, but you can also use one that's got facets on it, one flat face or whatever. You might want to use this and use percussion with the small edge here, or you can use rounded end. Sometimes it's beneficial to use that flat spot when striking. Strike down to clip off the projection sticking out. I've been using this a little bit lately, but I prefer the round one because I don't really have to think about where I'm going to hold it. And I just rough it out and get the basic shape. I take off all the thin spots. Now in this piece we can't afford to lose too much width. And I've got to think about the strategy on what where to take the flakes off. I'm going to remove this first, so I need to move this edge closer to that higher spot. So I'm just brushing, and all that did was it lowered the edge down closer to this high spot. So when I start to shoot flakes, it'll shoot flakes across the top of that high spot. Now, on the actual artifacts, hammer stones a lot of times, or abrading stones, have a little cut in the stone itself. It'll fit right on the edge, and I can see why they do that, because if you got a smooth round stone and you're doing this, you could easily slip off and cut your finger. I've been doing it long enough so I know to be careful, but I've cut myself plenty of times, believe me. I think you can see a spot right there. Anyway, when you abrade the edge, what you're doing is you're preventing it from crushing. And crushing, it steals a lot of energy. If the edge is real thin, it just crushes and compacts, and it absorbs all the energy, and nothing gets transferred to the interior of the stone. It just all gets stopped right here. So when you create a strong platform, what you're doing is you're creating a striking platform that's strong enough to send energy into the stone. For some of you, this is going to be boring, so might want to skip to the last video or something. Okay, that's basically it. Good enough. I'm going to start here and knock off this ridge. And when I teach my kids how to flint knap, I tell them, look for the points. Where do I hit? Okay, well, look for the points. See the point sticking out? Right there. That's what I call a point. You put your tool right on that and knock that off in the direction of that ridge. And there's a little bit of pressure holding that on there. It's not suspended in midair. I do make contact and put a little bit of pressure by pushing upward on the workpiece and gripping it. I'm actually gripping it with my leg behind my knee. And when you hit, I snap hit. I don't put too much force right now because it's on the end and also because there's not much material to remove. And just snap it. Now, I'll need to hit harder next time, but again, you have two options now. You can hit it on this point here, or we can make another point right next to it. Scratch it back a little bit. You can see we can hit this spot or that spot. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up further to the tip and hit that spot right there. See if I can knock off that ridge. This flake wasn't very well done. Let's try it again here. That was much better. Yeah, it broke up, so I can't reassemble that, but you get the idea. Make sure that that point is not weak. You want it to be strong enough to remove that. Set it on top. Let's say I go about a 16th of an inch inward. It varies quite a bit. When you get down to the final finished product, you can maybe go a 32nd of an inch from the edge. If you're working on a larger piece, you might go up to an 1/8 of an inch inward. That's why I don't like to put notches on here, because the position that I rest the tool on changes. Right now, I guess about a 16th would work. Of course, you'll get used to it over time. Set it right on top, and it's angled, so it's almost at 90 degrees to that ridge. The angle is acute right there. It's almost 90, well, maybe not, maybe about 80 degrees. With antler, you'll need a sharper edge than this. And it followed that ridge. Now you're set up to follow this ridge or that ridge, and that bulb of percussion is getting smaller. So again, the steps are, make sure that the platform is strong. Make sure you have a ridge to follow. Make sure that you put it at the right spot with the right amount of bite, you know. And then snap it when you hit it. Can start to thin it down. You notice I'm not taking off really, really thick flakes. I'm just kind of wearing it down. One reason is because I'm working right on the point. Another reason is it's difficult to mess it up when you do it that way. Yeah, I'm going to hit this little point right on the tip there. And just slowly work it. And I use this abrading stone down here quite a bit, just by rubbing the edge on it, and you put some force behind it. You're not gently rubbing it. You're putting some force behind it, and you're rubbing it, abrading it, so that there's no weak spot on the end of there. There's several points sticking out that I could hit. The ridge here, I could hit right there. There's a little bit of a ridge here. I could hit there, but that step right there doesn't look too good, so I probably wouldn't hit there. I'd probably hit right next to it right there. And right here. So, point sticking out right there. So I would either hit it right here, right here. And the angle is something you get used to over time. So I don't know exactly what angle to hold it at. That's the basics behind removing these thin flakes. I'll go a little faster in the next video.